arm soldiers to go for, you know, to 7-Eleven for it. We don't need these things, really. And of course, that's why we consume 360 gigajoules per capita, because we have these things, really, right?
So this gets back to this other, on the blog, and again, the blog gets at some of the same questions you've explored as well, which is, I recently wrote a piece asking the question, do we need to outgrow growth? And this gets at Herman Daly, economist. There's a growing body of economists who are thinking about new measurements, new ways to measure progress. So if we just shift away from the idea that gross national product or things that grow is the norm, the expectation toward, are we doing well? Are we living decent lives? But is that doable? Can we unlearn these habits?
Well, that's the tough stuff, because you see the thing, it's doable, but it's doable only by catastrophe and crisis. It's not doable voluntarily. People voluntarily will not abandon their hammers, you know, somewhere, you know, in the fields, and people will not start walking to the nearest 7-Elevens. That's just the thing. It will happen because it will have to happen because of the economic squeeze or strategic squeeze or Chinese squeeze or whatever squeeze. It will happen eventually, but voluntarily, the chance of it is very slim. Look, I tell you the secret about how to transform the world with one kind of behavior only. Maybe somebody will know. What is the thing you could do to have the biggest impact on this planet as an individual, if everybody would follow you? If you do it individually, forget it. But what we could do as individuals to have the biggest impact on this planet, strategic, environmental, political,